Many students have a real fear of fractions. However, if you can remember what a fraction represents and a few mathematical rules on how to work with them algebraically, you will be able to face fractions with confidence. In this video, we will review how to multiply and divide fractions. Let's get started. We should start by defining exactly what a fraction is. A fraction represents a ratio of a part to a whole, or part over whole. The value above the division line is referred to as the numerator, and the value below the division line is the denominator. To multiply fractions, simply multiply straight across, meaning the numerator times the numerator divided by the denominator times the denominator. Let's look at a couple of quick examples. 2/3 times 2/5. As we said earlier, we're going to multiply straight across. So we're going to have 2 times 2 over 3 times 5, which is equal to 4 over 15. So our answer is 4/15. Now let's try another one. We're going to try 4/7 times 3/11. Again, it's the same concept. We're going to multiply 4 times 3 divided by 7 times 11, which gives us 12 over 77. 12/77. Pretty simple, right? Now let's take a look at dividing fractions. Dividing fractions involves a slightly different process. Before we jump into the mechanics of the process, let's start by looking at an intuitive example of dividing a fraction by 2. The effect of dividing by 2 is simply cutting the fraction in half, or multiplying the fraction by 1 over 2. So 4/5 divided by 2 is really the same as saying 4/5 times 1/2. Then it's going to be multiplied across just like we did before. So we have 4 times 1 is 4 over 5 times 2 is 10. Which then simplifies to 2 over 5. So in other words, 2/5 is half the size of 4/5. Similarly, dividing a fraction by 3 would result in a fraction that is 1/3 the size of the original. 2/5 divided by 3 is the same as saying 2/5 times 1/3. Which gives you 2/15. So 2/15 is 1/3 the size of 2/5. Before we generalize this process, let's review some important terminology. Consider the relationship between 2 and 1/2. These numbers are called reciprocals of one another, which means that the numerator of one number is the denominator of the other, and vice versa. Remember that 2 can be written as a fraction by writing it over 1, like this. 2 over 1. Therefore, 2 over 1 and 1/2 are reciprocals. The same can be said of 3 and 1/3, because 3 can be written as 3 over 1. Therefore, 3 and 1/3 are reciprocals. With this in mind, what pattern do you see in the process for dividing fractions? The process of dividing fractions is the same as multiplying the first fraction by the reciprocal of the second. A shorthand version of this wordy explanation that may help you remember the division process is keep, change, flip. You keep the first fraction as is. Then you change the operation from division to multiplication, and you flip or take the reciprocal of the second fraction. Once this adjustment is made, simply follow the rules for multiplying fractions by multiplying the numerators and dividing by the product of the denominators. Here's an example using the keep, change, flip process. Say we want to divide 3/5 by 7/5. We'll keep the first fraction as is. Change the operation from division to multiplication, and flip the second number. Now we just multiply our numerators. 3 times 5 is 15, over 5 times 7 is 35. And then from there, we simplify to 3/7. I hope this video was helpful. Thanks for watching and happy studying.